Hi everyone, at the end of this video, you're going to be able to use the Measure Up digital multimeter. So, this multimeter that we see here has a couple different things going on. We have our LCD display, we have a hold button, we have our backlight, we have a rotary switch to change what we want to measure. We have a couple comm terminals. Okay, so what do these different buttons do? So the hold button is used if we want to hold a measurement. The backlight display is used to illuminate the display. So let's go ahead and turn this on. So you can see if I want to light that up, I can. All right, now let's talk about the different ranges that are available. So right now it's set to off. From here to here, we're measuring DC voltage. So this first setting measures voltage in the approximate range of 200 millivolts, 2000 millivolts, 20 volts, 200 volts, 500 volts. So those are different ranges that we have to manually select depending on what range we want to measure. Okay, we also have a 500 and 200 volt AC setting. We have a continuity setting. This will test whether there is a continuous path for a current to flow. We have a square wave output that we can send, which is a nice feature. Then we also have all of our current measurements, starting from 10 amps here all the way down to 2000 microamps. And then over here, we have our resistance measurements, starting at 200 ohms here, working our way up to 200 mega ohms. So I get a lot of students who don't know or understand how these access terminals work. They think that it doesn't, or they either don't know what they mean, or they just leave them how they get them. So, you know, maybe they'll have the terminal set up like this. They go to take a voltage measurement and they get 0 volts and they don't understand why that's going on. So it's very important. Typically, under normal circumstances, you are always going to have the black probe connected to the common ground. Now, depending on if we're going to measure voltage or resistance, if we're going to measure voltage or resistance, we're going to use this terminal right here. However, if we're going to measure current, we need to connect the red probe to this terminal here. So I'm going to connect my probe to the middle terminal, and I'm going to measure the voltage of this battery. So we're going to set our voltage over here. Okay, so here I have a 1.5 volt AA battery. All right, I'm going to set my voltage over here to 20 volts because that is in the similar range as 1.5 volts. Okay, now I'm going to connect the black to the cathode, the red to the anode of the battery. And I'm getting 1.6 volts. So we're looking good. This battery is good. It still has plenty of juice in it. So we're happy there. Now what happens if I would have had this set to say 200? Now what's going to happen is, am I still going to get a reading? Let's find out. Okay, so I get 1.5 volts still. So we're looking good. So we, you know, even in this range, I'm still getting a good answer. Okay, what if I had this set to 200 millivolts? Let's see what happens here. Okay, so I'm getting open line. So what that's telling me is that I'm out of range for this particular voltage. If I go up a notch, let's see if it works this time. Okay, so right here, you notice I'm getting a measurement of 1,610. Now, that's a correct measurement. The thing about this particular meter is it doesn't give you the units that it's in. So you have to understand that you are measuring in millivolts. So you have 1,611 millivolts, which is equal to 1.6 volts, approximately. So everything still looks good. So even if you aren't exactly right on your setting, you know, depending on what you're trying to measure, as long as you're pretty close, this meter's going to pick it up. But you do have to be a little careful. All right, so now let's get a measurement of a resistor. So right now my meter's off. I'm going to set it to 200 kilo-ohms. I know that this resistor is in that general vicinity, so I'm going to take a measurement of that resistor, and I get 99.6 kilo-ohm. So I have a 100 kilo-ohm resistor right here, and it looks like it's off 100 by a little bit. Now, what would happen if I would have set this to 20 mega ohms and taken a measurement? Okay, I still get a reading, 0.09. So I have to remember that's 0.09 mega ohms. 0.09 mega ohms is going to be the same as a 100 kilo ohms or 99 kilo ohms. Okay, now if I was at 20,000, let's see what happens. All right, I get open line. See, I've exceeded the range of what that resistance can do. So 20 kilo ohms is my max value that I can go to. So I've exceeded that, so I'd have to move my meter up to get a measurement there. And the same would happen with the 2,200 ohm settings. Okay, so you should Okay, so that was the basics of how to use the Measure Up digital multimeter. It's a pretty simple tool. It doesn't have some of the auto ranging features that some of the nicer meters have, but it can do quite a bit. There are some limitations to the meter. Obviously, there's certain voltage limitations. Spec wise, the meter claims it can go up to 500 volts. I would personally not trust this meter at 500 volts unless you have a very, very low current that you could be dealing with. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please like the video. And if you have extra questions, put them in the comment section.